In this problem, we're going to derive a rate expression for a mechanism that's of the Michaelis-Menten type, and that we're going to use a steady-state approximation. But the detailed mechanism is actually different than the simplest case of Michaelis-Menten, because we have an enzyme that reacts with a substrate 1 to produce enzyme substrate complex number 1. Right, and then this can either come back apart to reform the free enzyme in S1, or it can react with a second substrate molecule to produce a product molecule and then the free enzyme. And we just want to derive a rate expression according to the steady state approximation for this type of problem. And so to do this, we'll first recognize that what we want is to find the rate of product accumulation, which is the rate of reaction 3. And we assume that each reaction step is elementary, and so therefore we have a concentration dependence of first order in enzyme substrate complex 1 and in substrate 2, and an associated rate constant K3. ES1 is something that, again, as we talked about before, we can't really measure in a very easy way. We know the total concentration of enzyme that we've added at the beginning of an experiment, usually, but we don't necessarily know what the concentration of enzyme is that has a particular, that is in a particular state on which it's bound to substrate 1. Okay, but we'll use the steady state approximation to solve for this. And what we'll assume is that there's no net accumulation of this enzyme substrate complex with time. So its first derivative with respect to time is equal to 0. And the enzyme substrate complex 1 is formed in reaction 1 and depleted in reactions 2 and 3. And so we just use elementary rate laws to describe those reactions. So we have a K1 for the first reaction, times concentration of enzyme to the first power, times concentration of S1 to the first power. And for the second reaction, we have a K2, so we subtract off, because it's a consumption reaction, this reaction is K2 times concentration of ES1. And then this rate of product formation for the third reaction that we've already written up. So minus K3 times concentration of ES1 times concentration of S2. And this gives us one equation in terms of two unknowns. So concentration of free enzyme and concentration of enzyme substrate complex. And we can solve for one in terms of the other, and we'll do that here just by collecting terms. All right, so we have now one equation and two unknowns relating free enzyme to enzyme substrate complex in terms of some constants and some concentrations of substrate. They're more easily measurable. And so we need another equation, and this is where the total enzyme that we have comes in. So we know that the total concentration of enzyme, which should be fixed during the reaction if enzyme is not consumed, is a fixed number that we added at the beginning, right? And that's equal to the concentration of free enzyme plus the concentration of enzyme that's bound to substrate. All right, so I'm putting the one that's bound to substrate first in this expression. Now we can basically combine these two equations to solve for ES1, the concentration of ES1, in terms of the total enzyme concentration. In other words, we can eliminate the free enzyme concentration from our expression, right, by plugging in the right-hand side of the equation of the upper equation into the lower equation. And now we can remember that the rate of product formation is just equal to K3 times this concentration of ES1 times the concentration of S2. All right, and we now have an expression that we can solve to get the concentration of ES1 in terms of the total enzyme concentration, some kinetic parameters, and concentrations of the two substrates that we're feeding to the reactor. And so we'll combine that top equation, the topmost equation, with the bottom equation to solve for the rate of formation of product. Right, we get an expression that looks a lot like a Michaelis-Menten type expression. Right, we have a total enzyme in the numerator. Right, we have a K3. We have both of the substrates in the numerator. And then in the denominator, we see that we have two additive terms that can have different levels of importance. All right, we'll start collecting some terms. We'll refer to the total enzyme times K3 as Vmax, which is exactly the same as was done in the classical Michaelis-Menten derivation. Okay, and so now, according to this mechanism, we're asked to answer the question of whether the reaction rate will ever be less than first order in S2? And the answer is that it can be. All right, if we look at the denominator, we see that there's a possible dependence on the concentration of S2. So if the concentration of S2 is very large, then that term K3 times the concentration of S2 becomes very large. Okay, and so it can become large enough that it dwarfs the other terms. Right, and in that case, we would have a zeroth order overall dependence on the concentration of S2, because both the numerator and the denominator would have a linear dependence on the concentration of S2. All right, so no overall dependence of the rate on the concentration of S2. Right, and this makes physical sense, because if we have enough S2 around that third reaction is very fast compared to the first two reactions, then adding more won't help because we're being held up by the supply of ES1 to that last reaction.